morning, boys, and good morning, girls. How are you? I hope that you are very, very, very good, great, and fantastic in the second day of this new week. Espero que se encuentren super, super bien, chicos. Today we are continuing talking about the adjective. Yes, we have more adjectives to learn. Very good, boys and girls. Remember that this adjective finish in ed. A ver, chicos, recordando nuestra clase pasada, cuando los adjetivos terminan en ed es porque se va a dar la descripción de an animal, un animal, a thing, una cosa, a situation, una situación, or just a person, de una persona. What do you think? What did you remember? Because we know it, ya lo sabemos. Very good, boys and girls, ¿no? Cuando terminan en ed es porque vamos a dar descripciones de una persona. Very good, not talking about a person. We are going to start with this. Vamos a empezar con este de aquí. Se escribe surprise. Yes, we are going to spell it. Vamos a deletrearlo. Repeat after me. S-U-R-P-R-I-S-E-N-D. Very good. Surprised se escribe. How did you pronounce this? ¿Cómo lo pronunciamos? De esta manera. Surprised. Repeat after me. Surprised. Very good. Again. Surprised. Excellent. What does it mean? I'm surprised because he gave me the best gift. Estoy sorprendida porque me dio el mejor regalo. Surprised, very easy. Sorprendida o sorprendido. Recuerden que no hay género. Very good. Continuing with the other adjective. Mi siguiente adjetivo se escribe así. Terrified. Terrified. With double R. Con doble R aquí ya, chicos. We are going to spell it again. Lo vamos a deletrear de nuevo. Repeat after me. T E double R I F I E N D. Remember, recuerden, ya hemos visto el alfabeto, el abecedario. Y en inglés, I. En inglés, E. Very good. Don't confuse. Terrified. How do you pronounce this word? ¿Cómo lo pronunciamos? De esta manera. Repeat after me. Terrified. Repeat after me. Terrified. The stress syllable, la mayor fuerza de voz, le vamos a dar acá. Terrified. Again. Terrified. What does it mean, terrified? Aterrado. Yes. Más que un miedo, es aterrado. Yes, for example. The children were terrified because they watched a horror movie. Yes, los niños estaban aterrados porque vieron una película de terror. Yes, therefore they were terrified. Por ello ellos estaban aterrados. Very good. And they wouldn't or couldn't sleep. Very good, boys and girls. Continue with the other adjective. Se escribe de esta manera. Frightened. Frightened. Spelling it. Vamos a deletrearlo. Repeat after me. F. R. I. G. H. T. E. Remember. N. E. N. D. ¿No? La final, la E y la D. Se pronuncia de esta manera. Frightened. Repeat after me. Frightened. Con la D al final. La pronunciación le vamos a dar la D al final. Frightened. Again, boys and girls. Frightened. What does it mean, frightened? It's similar to this, but it's less, ¿no? Un poquito menos que este de aquí. Asustado. I can be frightened and I can sleep. But if I terrify, I couldn't sleep, ¿no? Yo puedo estar asustado, pero después puedo dormir. If I terrify, si estoy aterrado, I couldn't, no podría sleep. Very good, boys and girls. Frightened, asustado, terrified, aterrado. Continue with the other. Se escribe así. Fascinated. with S and C. We are going to spell it too. Vamos a deletrearlo también. Repeat after me. F A S C I, remember, N A T E N D. Y se pronuncia de esta manera. Fascinated. Repeat after me. Fascinated. Tit. Fascinated. Again. Fascinated. The stress syllable, la mayor fuerza de voz está en la fa. Very good. Fascinated. Excellent. Fascinated. Very easy. Muy, muy fácil, chicos, de adivinarlo, de acertar el significado de esta palabra. What does it mean, fascinated? Fascinado, yes. I'm fascinated for your ring. Estoy fascinado, encantado de tu anillo. Yes, very good. Fascinated, fascinado, encantado. Finally, finalmente, the last adjective. Interested, así se escribe, interested. La pronunciación es así. Interested. Repeat after me. Interested. Yo no digo interested, no. Yo digo interested. Again, practice. Interested. One more time, una vez más. Interested. Interesado. Remember, recuerden que termina en ed y yo estoy hablando de mi interés, un interés mío, de una persona. No, for example, I can say, por ejemplo, yo puedo decir, I'm interested on read or in reading this book. Estoy interesado en leer ese libro. Yes, very good. Interested, interesado, una persona. Si yo digo interesting con ing, porque ya hemos visto ese adjetivo con ing al final, es interesante. A situation, ¿no? For example, I can say, or a thing even, ¿no? O una cosa, algo incluso, ¿no, chicos? For example, I can say, yo puedo decir, that movie, esa película, was interesting. Estaba interesante. Interesting, interesante. Interested, interested, interesado en. Interesting, con ing, interesante. Don't forget that. Interesting, interesante. Interested, interesado. Remember that this finish with it, with the, ¿no? Recuerden que este termine con la T. Termina con la de interested, interesado, interesting, interesante. Don't forget that, boys and girls. Very good. We are going to practice again the pronunciation. Let's start. Surprised. Repeat after me. Surprised. Sorprendido. Terrified. Aterrado. Very good. Frightened. Frightened. Asustado. Fascinated. Fascinado. And finally, interested, interesado. Very good, boys and girls. I know you did it great. Now copy this and give me your pronunciation. Don't forget that. Take care and goodbye, boys and girls.